When I planned this lecture and the course, I first thought I should do it the traditional way of starting, very simple, and maybe give a crash introduction into Haskell, then do some simple Pluto's contracts and slowly add more complicated stuff. But then I decided it would be more interesting, especially for the first lecture, to showcase a more interesting contract and just demonstrate what Plutus can do, and then use that to look at certain concepts in more detail and explain them in more detail. So the code for this course will be in this GitHub repository. It's at input output HK and then Plutus Pioneer program. So in order to build the code, first you have to clone this repository, the one whose address I just showed you. Then you need to clone a second repository, the Plutus minus apps repository, also belonging to the input minus output minus HK organization. Actually, Plutus comes in two parts. In the previous iterations of the course, that wasn't the case. There, everything was in one repository called Plutus. But in the meantime, this has been split into two parts. There's still the old Plutus repository, and then there is this Plutus minus apps repository. So roughly you can say the Plutus repository is for on-chain things and the Plutus minus apps repository is for off-chain things. And the Plutus minus apps repository references the Plutus repository, which means if you get the right version of the Plutus minus apps repo, then you automatically also have the right Plutus dependency. So the first step, if you want to build the code, is to clone these two repositories, the one specific to the course and the Plutus minus apps repository. One important thing you have to do is you have to configure your local NICs correctly. So in this Plutus minus apps repo, if you look at the README in this chapter, NICs, it's explained how to set up the IOHK binary caches. And you really should do that because a lot of the dependencies are already cached there, and that makes the builds much faster. So just follow the instructions here. So the next steps are now the same for every week of this course. So now we are in the first week, but it will work the same for the coming weeks. So I'll explain it now, and then you know how to build the code for all the weeks of the course. So first, you have to go into the right directory in the course repo. So after you've cloned it, the top directory is this Plutus minus Pioneer program, and then you have to go into the code directory and then into the folder for the appropriate week. So in our case, week 01. Now you have to figure out which version, which GitHub commit of the Plutus apps repository this week uses. And how can you find that out? Well, in each of these folders for each week, there will be a Kabal project file, which, if you're familiar with Haskell, gives information exactly like that, which versions of various dependencies you use, in particular dependencies that cannot be found on Hackage, the normal code repository used for Haskell development. So if we look at this Kabal project file, then there is some stuff in the beginning, and then here come the all the dependencies that we pull from various places on GitHub. And the first one is the Plutus minus apps repository. And here you see the tag. So this is the GitHub commit of the Plutus minus apps repository that this week's code is using. So we copy this tag and then we change to the Plutus minus apps repo, the clone that you made. And now we check out that tag that we just looked up. So I just paste it here and check out that version. Once you have done that, now we have the correct version, the one that's used by this week's code of the Plutus minus apps repository. Now in this Plutus minus apps repository, after checking out the correct tag, we run nix shell, nix minus shell, And if you do that for the first time, it can take quite a while until everything has built. Once you are in this Nix shell, you from inside the shell change back into the code repo for the course of this week. And then you can do a Cabal build. And this can also take quite some time the first time you do it. And that's it. In my opinion, that's the easiest and most reliable way to build the code examples for this course. If you want a REPL, you can now also from this Nix shell do as usual a Cabal REPL. Another very useful thing to have is Haddock documentation for the various Plutus libraries. And those you can also create easily using Nix from inside the Nix shell if you are back in this Plutus minus apps repository and just enter the command build and serve docs. And again, this can take a while. In my case, I had built them before, so it immediately starts the server. But when you do that for the first time, it will first have to create the docs. And then it serves that on this port 8002. And this is now not what you probably want. That's just the like high-level documentation of Plutus. So if you want to go to the Haddock, then you need to go to slash Haddock. And this is then Haddock documentation for all the Plutus libraries. So it's very comprehensive. And because it's not just a static file, but an actual web server, you can also nicely search for things with Control S, and then this search box opens and you can look for something, for example, own payment key. And there you go. You have Haddock documentation.